Do you know what LGBT stands for?
LG, lesbian, gay,
bisexual,
transgender,
lesbian, gay, bi, transgender.
Nowadays, there's often no need to explain what LGBT means. But people who don't identify as heterosexual or cisgender, and also don't identify as lesbian, gay, bisexual, or transgender, are spearheading a movement to add more letters to the traditional LGBT acronym.
Have you heard of the acronym LGBTQA+?
Absolutely not. No, I don't want to be wrong, and yes.
Not the A part, but the LGBTQ+.
So what does QA+ mean, and why is it important? Acronym LGBT is not the end-all be-all of non-heterosexual and non-cisgender identity. In reality, this community expands far beyond four categories. By adding new letters and symbols, LGBTQA+ aims to provide visibility for everyone in this group, a community based in representation and equality for all.
Do you know what the Q might stand for?
I don't know a lot of Q words.
I mean, I know they include Q for queer.
I've always done it as queer or questioning.
Historically, the word queer has been used to refer to gay people in a derogatory way.
I don't know, I always feel like it had a bad connotation. Back in like the 70s when like it was like terrible to be gay and it was like, oh, like stop being so queer, and like it's seen as being like weird and different.
But in the 1990s, the LGBT community moved to reclaim this word and take away its power as a slur. These days, queer is often used as an umbrella term.
Isn't it people who do not fall into just heteronormativity?
I think of anybody under the LGBTQA, you know, spectrum in any kind of form that can't be included with a specific letter.
Queer is also an identity that some people use to acknowledge that their sexuality, gender, or both might be non-binary. It could also stand for questioning, as a way to acknowledge that even if you aren't sure of your identity quite yet, you're still a part of the community.
So what do you think the A stands for?
I would guess anonymous.
Asexual. Yeah, I watched a video on that recently.
I personally think it's asexual.
Asexuality is an identity for those who lack sexual attraction altogether.
It's just not feeling that outright. It's also how I identify.
Adding the A to LGBTQ provides representation for a sexual minority that often goes completely unrepresented in the mainstream.
It's very important to me to feel like I'm included in a space that a lot of people might say I'm not.
So what could possibly be left to cover in the LGBTQA acronym?
What identities do you think might fall under the plus?
Gray romanticism.
I have a friend who's like pansexual, so that would be included. I for like intersex.
Non-binary.
Identities like genderqueer, demisexual,
bigender.
So why is it so important for people to feel represented?
Well, I guess it's like counterintuitive to have it be enclosed like LGBT, like these are the only people who are part of it.
It's just important to try to take into perspective the experiences of everyone.
And like, I know that I didn't know of other gay people when I was like 10 and 12, you know. If there had been more identities to look under, that would have been amazing for there to be more letters.
It adds credibility, and also it makes you just feel better to know that what you're doing is happening to a lot of other people. You're not weird, you're not isolated.
Expanding the traditional LGBT acronym to include QA+ provides visibility for identities that have never before been a part of the sexual and gender identity conversation. Until now. Visibility leads to acceptance, and acceptance leads to the end goal of everybody being okay with who they are.